Hello, everybody. Welcome back. We are on episode number 10 with our Oxygen Not Included achievement run. In the previous episode, we did some corrections to the automation. We changed some of the settings on our ranches, and we kept digging for more calories. It looks like we're keeping up with it so far. Probably have to do more mush bars until we finish up with having 8 hatches per ranch. And we are going to continue with the incubators and play with the timing if we need to. Let's get started. I would really like to finish the bathroom today. I think that that's a good goal. I don't know if we're going to accomplish that, but I think it's definitely a necessity. We now have a manual airlock that we need for this room over here. Probably need some more mush bars so they can turn that into the mush fry. That'll give us, 10 of those will give us 10,000 calories. And we do have some duplicates not, oh. Let's change some of these priorities. So we need to kind of focus on the calorie uptick here. Let's do, you hit the button over here and it deprioritizes everything. But then we'll just change that back to higher priority on the cooking. We are going to do the same thing for Frankie. That way, the biggest thing they go for is cooking. Even when things have a higher priority for them, they will go to the cooking. Still not sure about this automation duplicate motion sensor, but we'll see if it works, and if it doesn't, maybe we'll adjust it in some way. Maybe I have to do it on the side, put one of these tiles this way and then turn it to the side or something. Wait a second. What if, what if we did, we'll just watch this and we'll change it. If it doesn't work, I'm going to try a weight plate instead, because you'll have one duplicate on here performing the crushing right here, so I could change that to a weight plate. Maybe that'll work instead. Is that plenty of time? I think it is. Gossman does a wonderful job. I think it is a good amount of time. Now we don't have to play with the manual stuff. What else? What else can we get going here? You know, it would be really nice for everybody to have a location to eat. Okay, so this did not work. So I want to deconstruct you, and then we are going to put in a weight plate right here. Right. Is it because we don't have enough? I think it's because we don't have enough of it right now. I will solve the problem. It's going to happen. So let's look at the germs here. Oh man, look at those germs. Yeah, we need to take care of that. It's getting icky over there. We don't have, oh, we do have the deodorizer, so we could, let's just put a deodorizer right here. they're done with that research. We are going to get... What was the next in line? I'm getting all of my days mixed up here. Insulated tile will be good. Oxygen, not oxygen, gas reservoir would be good. But I think, battery. There we go. We want the smart battery. And then we need to change this. I keep doing this, but there's a reason for it. I don't want them breathing in the gross oxygen, because then they'll have yucky lungs and then they breathe more and then it makes you have less oxygen. They're taking care of this. Let's deconstruct that automation wire. So we can't put a weight plate. I wonder, how would we turn this on? Let's take a look at the sensor. If we go like this, we're doing it. We have to try, because it is essential. And this is the first time that I'm trying this method. I always have it next to the food, but I've never tried it next to the rock crusher. So that's the first time for me. I think overall we're doing really well though, even though we're close to cycle 30. As soon as we get enough hatches in all of these, and we stop adding a bajillion things for them to do, them as the duplicants, then they will catch up and then they will start focusing on what we're telling them to do. Let's see, are any of these close to hatching? No. Kind of. Yes. No. Kind of. No. No. Okay. And then let's add hatch eggs to this. I don't know why it's not there. All these guys are happy. All these ones are happy. And all these ones are happy. Good. Yeah, we're gonna need more of this. Who got an attribute? Steve did. Machinery skill to level 3. Sweet. So let's look at some of these different skills. Machinery increases operation speed, run speed for athletics, science, it's research skill leveling and geotuning, how fast you cook with the cooking cuisine, treatment speed for medicine, strength, how much you can carry, and tidying speed. Decorating speed for creativity. Oh man, a lot of stuff for agriculture. Harvesting speed, tending, seed chance, and farmer's touch. Duration. Okay. wrangling speed and groom effect. We knew about that. Rocket speed with a better pilot. That's why some of these are really important. Alright. Digging speed and attack damage with excavation. Okay. Cool. So those are just some of the reasons why it's important to find good skills with specific traits. Alright, round, I think, 3. Trying to get this light to automate as someone is working on the rock crusher. Success! Awesome! Yes, that's what we want to see. I was very surprised that this way did not work, but this one does, so. Woohoo! Mission accomplished for that. We have a lot of food, mush bar, mush fry. Not a lot, I mean, but I think we're skating by. And since we're gonna stop on the research for a minute, this will be helpful to get most of this other stuff taken care of and completed. We have no cow! Where's our chefs? I only see one. One. Oh, Steve is asleep. So we have 8 in there. Do we have any eggs, or are they all hatchlings and hatches? I think they're all hatches and hatchlings. 6 in here, and 8 in here. So, to help with the food, we are going to change this one to 6 for a minute. And then we are going to turn one of them into barbecue. That way, we are in a good position. Thanks, Rowan. Because that'll give us 4,000 calories. Oh, man. Oh, that was only sandstone. I thought he was only carrying a little bit of the meat. No! Hold on here. I'm glad I caught this. No! He ate it! Oh, man. Forgot to change it. Yeah, unpermitted food. That's right. Yeah, there's a reason for that. We have meat, we have mush fry. We have mush bar. And how much meat does it take to make barbecue? I think it's 3,200. It is 3,200. Well, I suppose we should just let everybody eat that other section of meat. And then turn that back off afterward. Okay, we have 9 of that. We need more mush bars. 10 per cycle. That'll give us our 10,000. We have 2650. So our strategy is working. This one is lullabied, lullabied, lullabied. We're waiting for one of them to do this one, which I think Gossman is all over it. Thank you, Gossman. Have. Is everybody happy? Happy, 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 happy. Tiny baby, happy. Happy, 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 happy. Okay. We'll change this one back to 8. Let's turn the priority of these to a 7. Then our storage bins can be full of... Well, the auto sweepers will make sure that the critter feeder is fed. And that'll help with the amount of tasks that have to be performed in the day. Lots of mush fry. Let's take a look at our achievement here. Only 1600 so far. Okay. Ooh, that is not close by any means. We'll get there. We will get there. Every egg has been lullabied. Okay. Yeah, we aren't doing any research right now because we need to catch up. Ooh. Just in time. So now this will auto feed whenever this has lower than 500 calories, as long as there is stuff, or not calories, but 500 kilograms of sedimentary rock or sandstone. That's what the auto sweepers will do. It'll send it into the critter feeder from the storage bin. If we change the automation and we only send a green signal when the number is higher than 8, then the only thing it's going to do is send eggs when we reach that green signal. So right now we're going to leave the automation off since we aren't sending any eggs anywhere but over here. So, oh, we missed one of the eggs. Is the incubation time correct? It is correct. That's correct. That's correct. You're not ready yet. Okay. Actually, let's look at our graph. Okay. Yeah, we need to work on our calorie generation. We're trying. I'm trying here. Okay, we have another hatch. Let's see, how close are these other ones? Not quite, but they're getting there. This one will hatch soon. There we go. Wait a second. We missed the incubation time for that one. We are going to turn that one on. That way, That is what it is. Alright, now we can turn this back down to 10%. There we go. What other one didn't get it? I believe it was this one. Hold it! Come back! Yeah, run back. Stop in the name of hashes! And you didn't even do it! No! Oh, man. That's okay. It's fine. That's why we have multiple ranchers. Let's see. All right, so we are slowly getting there. Somebody, sing to this hatch. There we go. Gossman coming in clutch. Okay. It says we have insufficient oxygen generation. Let's take a peek. Yeah, that is not ideal. What I'd like to do is put some sort of oxygen generation up here in the cold biome. That is going to be a little difficult. So for now, let's see, what could we do? Well, for starters, let's get all of this stuff. And we are going to make a ladder all the way up there and probably put some sort of oxygen generation system in the cold area. And we do that because if you look at this guy, yeah, it's starting to get pretty hot. So we want to limit that as much as possible, and that's going to be really helpful to create oxygen in the cold biome. All right. So once that is done, we can probably put a few things here. I think we'll go, yeah, I think we'll do it like this. Leave a little ledge-ish. Take out those. And what I want to do here is make sure that the hot and the cold biome don't mix too much, because I don't want a ton of this ice to melt and then fall into the base and then have to clean it up. It's not fun, and it gets a little annoying, so we're going to avoid that if we can. We have 8. 8 and 8. Wow. Alright, we've got our 24 dupes. Not dupes. Oh, man, 24 dupes would be crazy. We have 24 hatches. They all hopefully are happy. We are catching up on the bathroom system here. We need power. Looks like it's being made. Everything is slowly coming together. Somebody do this. Like, yeah. Thank you. Okay, we are in a pretty good spot. I think we need to go turn this on Lullabied. So I think what we're gonna have to do is wait out the lullabies, so that way every time it comes around to the next day, it's on schedule with the green. Otherwise, it's gonna be off the schedule, and then we're not gonna get lullabied again. Kind of like what just happened right here. So if I keep forcing it by changing this and rotating back, it's never going to be on the right timetable. So I'm going to leave it as is and let it happen as it's supposed to. Otherwise, it's never going to work the way we want it to. Wow. We're finally starting to get a rhythm. I mean, I feel like we had a rhythm, but now I feel like we have a better rhythm than what we had before. Okay. They would have gotten stuck, and that would have been unfortunate. We don't want stuck dupes. So we can come down here and dig all this stuff up. Let's wait until all of that is done. I'm trying to see if we can get some more muckroot in the mix to alleviate some of the food pressure. Okay, I'm just gonna click on all of these to see the incubation timer. We'll have one egg. Alright, see, we got some muckroot. Maybe we'll get another hatch. That would be equally helpful. Oh, that reminds me. Let's go back to consumables and let's turn off the meat consumption. That would be helpful. More food. All right. We're making kind of a way for them to get down. Wait, no we're not. This would be making a way for them to get down, excuse me. I did that backwards. Whoops. Yeah, we do need some more oxygen generation. Let's do our this guy, maybe? Yes. We need to do, we don't have the insulated tile yet. No. Don't just go clicking on things, Dom. Come on now. We need you. Whoa. Oh boy. All right, let's see what we got. Bristleberry. Yes, more food. We cannot take another dupe right now. So what we need are goes from 1600 to 2000. Yes. Consumables, turn you off. Yes. There we go. This is good. This is really good. And then we'll also have Lullaby, Lullaby, Lullaby. No, not Lullaby. It's okay. We knew that was coming. Oh, wow. The Ada got a point in husbandry. That's what we want. More points. I wonder what that's considered. Is that considered the same as wrangling speed for lullabying speed? Does anybody know? I've never actually figured that out. Because it doesn't really tell you that. Please let me know. Send me a comment. I'd love to know if that is what affects how fast the lullabying goes. Because I know that some of the other duplicants that have a higher skill, it goes way faster. But I want to know what the real numbers are. I'm a numbers person. I love to know. No, don't do that. We want, like, two. Yes, 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 this is exactly how I want things to go, as planned. Let's see. Once we have insulation, we are going to start the process for insulating the base from the heat. So, I mean, even if we don't, we're at least going to create the border at a lower priority just to cushion us from things getting too hot. Eventually, we are going to start with the oxygen creation up there. I think in the meantime, let's deal with, let's put one of these over here, and then this is going to be high priority. I wanted it done like yesterday type. There we go. And then I can remove these because they are not as efficient as the smart battery. We have a hatch that we can just take care of right there. Are all these happy? They are all happy. That tip was awesome. I'm very thankful that I was given that tip about the eight hatches per, because I thought it was only six, and this makes it so there's going to be a lot more food coming in. Alright, what are you doing first? Okay, there we go. No, we're just gonna leave him there. Alright. Probably because it's lower on the priority list. We keep changing priorities on them, so they have to keep going back and forth. Which makes sense. Okay, we have reached the end of this episode on cycle 31. I went a little bit extra because we are in a really good place. We've had some changes to how we are doing things, and we've been managing our food consumption to food made ratios. I think that this is a good place to stop, and as always, if you have a comment or you have a suggestion, I'm always open to review them and see if it's something that we can do within the game, or gameplay rather. I also appreciate all of those that have subscribed. Thank you so much for supporting. I really, really appreciate it. It goes a long way. And if you haven't and you like my content, please do so. With that, I bid you adieu. Have a good rest of your day. We'll see you next time.